Hello everyone! Welcome back again to my channel! Ayan guys, huwag niyong kalimutang mag-subscribe.
Your Excellency, Your Majesty, the COVID-19 pandemic continues to cause disruptive worldwide far-reaching consequences. To survive, we need to make fundamental and systematic changes. And only a cohesive and responsive ASEAN can help us safely navigate out of this perfect storm of crisis. Greater cooperation and connectivity are vital to our region to thrive under the new normal that COVID-19 imposes on all of us. It is in this light that I welcome your plan of action for strengthening economic cooperation and supply chain connectivity, as well as the establishment of the ASEAN COVID-19 Response Fund. Certainly, these measures are only the first steps towards recovery and the continuation of our community building. To bridge the gap between today's crisis and the future we want, we must address the vulnerabilities that COVID-19 has revealed in our system. This pandemic has imposed the limitations of our healthcare and social protection system. It has laid bare the precarious situation of our workers at home and abroad, the viability of our micro, small, and medium enterprises, or the MSMEs, and the weaknesses of our supply chain networks. ASEAN is exhibiting cooperation in these areas. Our task now is to recalibrate our plans so that we can build back better. We must accelerate the implementation of the connectivity project to build resilient and sustainable regional supply chain. We have to maximize trade facilitation initiatives to promote the growth and the participation of MSMEs in the regional and global value chain. In order to improve the competitiveness of our workers and industries, we must have faster progress on human capital development. In this regard, we welcome the establishment of the CNTVET, or the TVET Council. We also want a stronger implementation of the ASEAN consensus and protection and promotion of the rights of the migrant worker. For all of us, this uniqueness and this pandemic is unlikely to be one-off event. We must therefore strengthen a region's capacity to address future infectious diseases outbreaks. We can do this by promoting research and capacity building on health technology and development. We must enable the ASEAN Center for Biodiversity to contribute in combating wildlife trafficking to prevent the spread of zoonotic diseases. Your Majesty, Excellencies, not everyone in the horizon is bleak. Viewed through the lens of environment, lockdowns have led to decreased energy consumption, thus reducing pollution. This pandemic has taught us that we must choose to be the nature steward not its abuses. Lockdowns have also forced us to take full responsibility of technology and innovation. The adoption of e-commerce, e-learning, video conferencing, and the artificial intelligence have all accelerated by the crisis. We expect many more positive outcomes from this development. We must cross border activity promoted as to expand the export opportunities for businesses, especially smaller ones. Force experimentation with the remote work could spur more service offshoring. This will spread throughout the regions while minimizing harm on the environment. As in previous cases, this pandemic has opened opportunities for green alternatives for our recovery. I join the leaders in asking our ministers to craft a recovery plan that is innovative and ambitious, and one that will lead us to a greener and more sustainable future. Your Excellency, Your Majesty, while the challenges we face due to COVID-19 are considerable, we must never forget that there are also other threats that can further undermine our efforts. The pandemic has not killed terrorism. It remains alive, lurking in the shadows. And in some countries, terrorist elements strike even during government relief operations. At a time of great need, these acts are unconscionable, and we must therefore be always on the alert. We also need to prepare for the disasters and natural calamities. The Philippines, September, is the most active period for typhoons. Already an effort under normal circumstances, relief activities become even more gravely complex as we battle COVID-19. We must also not lose sight of the geopolitical shifts that have occurred in the past 6 months. The rivalry between the United States and China was already well underway before the crisis. COVID-19 added a new layer of this complex relationship. The great powers will continue to draw us into their respective camps. We should continue to nimbly engage them in ways that most of us will benefit. We must insist on open and rules-based international order that gives all countries, large or small, not just one voice, but an equal standing. Even our region struggles to contain COVID-19. Alarming incidents in South China Sea occurred. We call on the parties to refrain from escalating tension and abide by the responsibilities under the international law, notably 1982 UNCLOS. We urge all parties to adhere to the rule of law and to their commitments to international instruments, including the 2002 Declaration on the Conduct of Parties in the South China Sea. A country coordinator for ASEAN-China dialogue relations, we face real constraints in dealing with the deliveries, deliverables. We must also not lose sight of the strategic interest in the China Sea. We must find innovative ways and exercise flexibility to achieve our common goals. We remain committed to work closely with the member state and China towards the early conclusion of an effective and substantive code of conduct in the South China Sea. Your Majesty, Excellencies, Asian solidarity and collective action have never been more critical than today. We thank Vietnam for its committed leadership in ASEAN under difficult times. Rest assured that the Philippines will continue working with ASEAN to realize our shared aspiration for a peaceful, prosperous, and secure future for our peoples. Thank you.